Glad you're here today. We're going to be talking about some really interesting stuff. First of all, changes to family law and how they could be affecting you, especially if you're going through a divorce. Lawyer Andrew Feldstein is here. Whenever we need a lawyer, it's intimidating. It's a hard process, and it can be financially draining, too. And that's why founder and managing partner of Feldstein Family Law Group, Andrew Feldstein, is here to talk about how you're advocating for changes to family law that hopefully will make difficult things like divorce and other family disputes a little easier to manage, plus be less burdensome financially, right?
That's right. Thank you for having me. And one of the things that I see in my practice is resolution can take a long time to achieve for people. It can be very costly, and it can be very harmful to their children, because when the parents are going through a fight, it leads down because the children pick up on the animosity, and it's hard on the children.
I bet you've seen some pretty crazy stuff going on between husbands and wives who are, trying to get back at each other in a divorce situation, right?
Well, it happens all too often, because especially if there's infidelity involved, there can be a lot of anger from one partner to the other partner. One of the things I always say to my clients is it's one thing to fight about money and trying to fight about money and to get a better deal. It's another thing when it comes to your children. And you always have to remember that you do not want to bring harm to your children. And I tell them, love your children more than you hate your former spouse, and keep that in mind.
So true. And these are kids who've probably, well, I know, I've been there myself as a kid. You see all the dysfunction happening in the family home before the divorce ever happens. So you've already got all that bad behavior being modeled for you, right? And then the divorce, and now it gets even worse. It's a nightmare.
It can be terrible for a lot of families.
What's the worst thing you've seen?
Well, in my practice, it's hard to say what the worst is. I've seen a lot of, I would say, very awful things. One of the worst things as a parent to go through is either A, your children or your child get abducted by the other parent, or situations where the other parent wants to erase you as a parent. And it's called parental alienation, and it's a situation where one parent goes on a campaign to vilify the other parent. And they have no clue about the damage they're doing to the children, because when a parent is using a child as a confidant and telling them all the negative things about the other parent, that's a message to the child. And it's a message to the child that half of them is bad and evil. And they don't think about the message and the harm it's causing to the children when they're doing that.
You're so right. They're just wanting to vent their own frustration. So you've got this advocacy campaign to help make family law better and hopefully avoid some of those pitfalls. What are the changes you want to make?
Well, we have a website that's dedicated to that, and we're inviting people to also include their comments. It's timeforjustice.ca. And what we want to do is we want to make the process faster, more efficient, and smoother for people. And a lot of people don't appreciate that part of the problems, we all hear the stories, legal fees are too expensive and too high. Well, there's a lot of problems in the system, and we're trying to say we got to look at those problems and how can we make things allow people to get to the resolution faster. Some examples of that are we've now in family law created something called unbundled services or limited retainers. Used to be a client would come into my office and I had to do everything for them. Now they can come in and say, I just want you to go to court on this day, or I just want you to draft materials. And that's something that our firm has started doing, and we have a website dedicated to that as well that helps people who want to do a lot of the work themselves and want to pick and choose where they need a lawyer.
What on earth could we even do for ourselves?
Well, here's the problem. If I say to somebody, what type of car would you want to drive? Most people might say, well, I want a really safe, great car. I want to drive a Mercedes-Benz or a BMW. Well, it's similar in family law. To hire us from beginning to end may be like getting the Mercedes-Benz or BMW, but not everybody can afford that. So people have to choose what they may want our help with and what they don't want our help with. And we give them options and we try to educate them, and it's called familylawhelp.ca. And it's another website that we use to help educate and give people the assistance to do things on their own.
Right. What's most essential to them? The a-la-carte menu.
Exactly, because they may have a limited budget. So pick and choose where you can spend your budget wisely to get to resolution.
Makes a lot of sense. You also think that the process should be made more electronic friendly. What do you mean by that?
Well, right now the process is horribly antiquated. If I want to start a court action, I have to create the paperwork at my office, then I send someone to the courthouse to get a court stamp put on it, then they have to go serve somebody, do something,
physically get in front of somebody's face,
which is fine, but then after that they have to go back to the courthouse again with something called an affidavit of service saying we served them. Then when I want to book a court date for what's called a case conference, I then have to write the other lawyer to get their dates. Then I write a trial coordinator to say, do these dates work? Then if I'm told those dates work, I now have to do up another document called a case conference notice, send it to the courthouse to get issued. Then I have to take that case conference notice, get it served, followed by then filing it again with an affidavit of service at court.
How long does that process generally take?
It can take a week or two, but it's not how long it takes. It's how much is a client paying for that, rather than me being able to go online, see the availability of the court, schedule the date with the other lawyer, and simply file my paperwork electronically.
You're right. Wouldn't that make so much sense?
It would, but we have a government that's not prepared to invest further in electronic filing.
Oh, my gosh. What else do you want to talk about? We've got about a minute and a half left. What's the most important thing you want people to take away from this?
I think it's really important. I get and I understand that when you're going through a separation or divorce, it's a lot like the loss of a loved one.
Mm.
You're mourning the loss of your marriage. And I understand it's a very troubling time. I went through it myself about a year and a half ago, and I know from doing this for the past 20 years and living through it, when you experience it, you are wondering and you're very stressed about how often am I going to see my kids? What is my relationship going to be like with my kids? How am I going to afford to live? What type of home I can afford to live? And we as family law practitioners and the system has to work towards allowing people to get to the end faster, because those stressors can be all consuming for people. And we need to reduce that.
That is brilliant. I'm so glad somebody's advocating for the people who are struggling through that difficult time. And ultimately, if we can make it a gentler process on the children, all the better, right?
Absolutely.
How do people get started if they want to get in touch with you?
They can call our office at 416-822-1239, but the easiest way is go on our website, separation.ca. And there's a plethora of information there, and we'll have links to our other websites that I've mentioned as well.
And they can see some of the services that are probably best suited for their needs and the ones they should hire you for and the ones that maybe they can take care of themselves.
Absolutely. And we also have a significant amount of video blogs. If you prefer watching videos to get information, we have it that way, as well as information in writing.
Thank you so much for being here today.
Thank you for having me.
Separation.ca for more information. When we come back, we'll talk about the new show here on Rogers TV called The Junior Economic Club.